Alrighty, there we go. Well, hello there. Here we are on a Tuesday, May 13th, 2020 at 9:04 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio. And now that we have that out of the way, okay, we have two cameras running, and we have the Canon EOS R with a Tamron prime lens on there, 35 millimeters, and it's a fixed lens, so it can't zoom in, but we're hoping to get a wider field of view there with that, and it's an f1.4, so it's going to let in a lot more light than the 2.8 that I have. And over here, oh, and we are recording onto an Atomos Ninja 5. It's a little 5-inch recorder. And over here on the Nikon P1000, we're recording onto the 7-inch Ninja Flame. And the only bright object I can see up in my skies is Venus over there in the west northwest. Let's go on up and take a look at her. Oh yeah, she's a pretty decent crescent tonight. According to the Sky Safari Pro app, Venus is about 13% illuminated. And what we can do, try that ND64 filter trick here. Oh yeah, that's a very nice crescent there. And I'm also trying out the Freewell magnetic filters, which is so much easier to put on. That's cool. I'm going to get a clip of that, and we'll be right back. All right, there we go. That's a decent clip. And I'm not sure until I go in the house and check out these videos, but I might overlay the wide field of view onto this zoomed in version like I've done before. So don't freak out. I like doing that to show where the planets are in the sky and the surroundings too, the landscape and trees and houses and everything else. And to see how high up it is. That's pretty cool though. Now there's really nothing else to see out here. It's not totally dark out yet, but that is the only light I can see besides my security light. That is just such a cool crescent though. My goodness. I really like that. And I do believe we're done with Sirius and Orion. That is until winter time comes. They're too low in the horizon after the sun goes down, so. Oh, and in case I forgot to mention it, we are using the Skywatcher tracking mount. If I didn't, Venus would have shot out of frame in a nanosecond. Especially when you're zoomed in that far, my gosh. I had hoped to get the morning planets of Jupiter and Saturn and Mars. And the moon too, but it was just way too bitter cold out this morning. We actually had some clear skies for a change, and but it was below freezing. I just could not come out and do that. It's getting harder and harder for me to do, so At the moment, it's about 50 degrees out or so, but it does feel cooler than that. And I wish I had something else to show you, but when you have late polluted skies like I do, you take what you can get. And if anything else pops up, I'll include it in here, but well, on the one camera, I can see a star up above that tree over to the left, but I can't see it by eye. It's so nice to have a sky that doesn't have all those airplanes up there during this worldwide lockdown. And I have a lot of airplane traffic around here. I live in between two major airports, between Pittsburgh and Cleveland. So this is really nice. Now, I don't know when next I'll be able to come back out, because our forecast is looking like it has been with clouds and rain and probably even, I don't know, maybe even more freezing temperatures. I hope not, but I think for the next week it'll be clouds and rain until I think next Tuesday. It's like we get one little brief day, sometimes only hours, of clear skies, and then boom, right back to the crap again. So I hope it's nicer out your way. Sorry there's not much else to show, but it's a pretty barren sky up here. So on that note, Venus and my trees and houses and myself are gonna wave goodbye from Ohio. So y'all take care. I hope you're all doing well and enjoying yourselves too. All right, bye now.